Thank you. Thank you so much for watching the video. I really hope you enjoyed it. So in this episode, we made a carving axe. This carving axe was inspired by the arjeplog axe, which I haven't researched that much, to be honest. I've just been looking at pictures, and from what I can tell, it looks like a pretty good carving axe. But I did take some, you know, I looked at the pictures and then I went to the forge and I started making it out of the image that I had in my mind. And yeah, it didn't come out as an arjeplog axe at all. And I don't even know the size measurements or anything about the arjeplog. I just saw the pictures and I've seen a guy in Sweden that makes replicas of the arjeplog who is really, really good. His name is Thor Berlin, and you can follow him on Instagram at thors_forge. And he makes really, really good replicas of that axe. But this is not a replica. This is just one of my axes that's inspired from that. So the material for the body, so the material for the body is wrought iron. The edge is 1045 or C45 as you call it here, high carbon steel or medium carbon steel depending on how you measure things. The handle is made out of Moser birch or Moser björk, as we say in Sweden, which is a really, really beautiful kind of birch that has these, you know, the bark grows inwards and it makes this really, really nice pattern in the wood. Usually I don't like to use birch for axes because I think it's a little bit too soft. However, Moser birch is also on the softer side, but it has this, you know, strength to it. That's really, really nice. And since this is a very small axe and you're not felling a tree with this axe, you're not applying that much forge, that much force when you're using it, I think it's gonna be pretty nice, to be honest. I also made a leather sheet, as I do to all my axes, and that's basically it. The wedge is out of wench wood that I have ordered. So a nice little axe, should fit in the backpack. That was the only description. That was the only thing that the new owner wanted it to do. So, and from there, I took all liberties to make whatever I wanted for him to see fit, what I saw fit to give to him. So, hopefully, he will enjoy this axe as much as I enjoyed making it. It was a really, really fun axe to make. Working with wrought iron is really, really fun from time to time. I wouldn't like to do it every day, however, but from time to time, it's a really, really fun thing, fun material to work with, because you have this challenge of always closing those weld gaps that show up if it's a bad piece of iron, or a cracked piece of iron, or a very delaminated piece of iron. So yeah, that's basically it. Once again, I really hope you enjoyed the video. If you liked the video, please leave a like on the video. Subscribe if you like videos like this, making axes and forging stuff, not only axes but mostly axes, because I really, really like axes. If you want to, you can follow me on my Patreon page, which you can do if you want to. The link is in the description. I'm also setting up a new website, so for those of you that have been going onto my website looking for prices and emails and stuff like that, I have been changing website host, and therefore the old email is no more. I can access old emails, but I can't send new emails from the new email. So the new email address is in my Instagram, which you also can find on in the description. So if you want to contact me, use the new email that's linked via my Instagram. The new website will probably launch, hopefully, if everything goes well. There's a lot of figuring out. There will also be a web store, a proper web store this time. If you want, that should probably launch around the beginning of November. There's a lot of tax things that you need to figure out for each country and stuff like that. So that takes a while, and I need professional help with that. So, but other than that, the website is actually finished. Hopefully it will launch in the beginning of November. So once again, thanks for watching. I really appreciate that you took time out of your day to watch one of my videos. Have a great time, and I'll see you in the next video. Goodbye.